My name is Harold Fibre from Soweto Wireless Super Group. I'm the CEO of the organization. So I will be like taking you to our organization, actually like focusing in terms of who we are, what we do, and why we do what we do, and how we did what we do, and the community impact that we had as a community network, and the developments in the past 12 months, but not necessarily in the past 6 months. So basically, we are an NPO that was formed back in 2010 with the primary goal of transforming communities through ICT development. So when we started back in 2010, we created a wireless network with just three nodes to actually like, test the concept that we had. So after receiving some funding from a local mobile operator, we actually like got some material, got some equipment to actually like create a network without any internet connectivity. But now we noticed that there was a slow intake in terms of what we were providing. So we decided to introduce an element of internet connectivity within the network itself. So 4 years down the line, we received a grant from Internet Society. Then that's when we started forging relationships with local businesses within the ICT sector within the country, including foundations. Our team consists of entrepreneurs, your activists, and also community leaders, and graduates which are well unemployed by them. So the community of Soweto, it basically has a population of 2 million with over 2,000 businesses and over 150,000 households. So by now the challenge is that we are facing social and economic challenges. So that's when we started tailor-making the network to actually assist in addressing those challenges, also involving young people, graduates and unemployed people to actually like make sure that we've got a strong impact in involving local people. Because one of the challenges that we also noted within the country is that there is high levels of unemployment within the country, especially for young people. Young people, they constitute about 70% of the unemployed, even graduates themselves. They are able to find opportunities. So ours is basically to transform communities through ICT development, and our vision is to operate a wireless network that will assist locals to address their social and economic challenges. Our mission is centered around operating a knowledge hub. That's where the research and development should be happening within the organization, with the intention to complement what the network will be offering. So the intended solutions and services that we provide as a network is supposed to be providing solutions when it comes to e-learning, because we noted that not a lot of people are able to access high-level tertiary education. So we thought that creating a network is actually making sure that we have content online for people to actually like go online to actually like, you know, study and gain some knowledge so that they can improve their own lives. And another thing we also consider of bringing in opportunities, like economic opportunities for local, especially for people who are looking for employment, businesses are looking for business opportunities, just to ensure that we are able to close the existing gaps and the disparities that are existing within the country. So what we do, we intend to continue bridging the digital divide by providing skills and basic computer literacy. That's what we've done. So whenever we get an opportunity, we just call on different people who are interested in getting ICT skills and then provide those particular skills for them. So what we are about making sure that information becomes more accessible, because as some of you can also be aware, the cost of communication is too high. So we try to make sure that people are able to access information at more, because initially it was supposed to be free, but due to sustainability of the network, that's when we started charging them very minimal fees compared to what other mobile operators are offering for the local community. So we are committed to creating an enabling environment for digital ecosystems, innovation, and entrepreneurship to thrive in our communities. So why did we do what we do? It's basically to help the marginalized amongst our society to address social economic challenges, as I mentioned, and to also provide innovative solutions that will impact the community and the small businesses that are within the boundaries of Soweto itself. We also committed to enabling people to take advantage of opportunities that are brought by the Internet of Things in the ICTs themselves. And another reason why we do what we do is to ensure that we have a smart and forward-thinking community who are digitally savvy. So the main reason that we do what we do is to ease the process of information access and also enable rapid innovation to take place. So how did we do that? How we did? We built partnerships with different stakeholders within the world, within the country, for backward support and infrastructure development. Like we have a data center that we've got access to that has been provided by Teraco. Teraco is one of the neutral data centers within the continent that is able to host content locally. So that's where we put in all our servers to ensure that whatever people are able to access, it's something that is locally hosted. So in terms of bandwidth, we had different types of service providers that we've been working with, like your Vox. Vox had provided us with bandwidth to support the offering that we're trying to introduce the chip. And ISO assisted us to actually get the actual equipment that we make sure that we do have the presence that is required within the community. We connected public hotspots as our main goal, but we also connect businesses and households, as I mentioned, to make sure that we are able to sustain the organization. We're working with volunteers and graduates, youth, entrepreneurs in all strata of our community. We've imparted digital skills to the very same people, including senior citizens, who have never gotten a chance to truly understand the ICTs. We've leveraged also on media platforms, to like your newspapers, your TV stations, your radios, amongst different types of platforms. So in terms of the community impact, we provide internet related services to local communities, because what we've done with, we are working with different internet cafes as a point of access for locals if they want to do some training or need some assistance in terms of them being able to actually make use of internet. Because some of them, they don't even have the devices that they can use to actually access the internet itself. So some of the things that we've been assisting with is to help students with registration for enrollment in teacher institution, because it's something that is now recently being done online. And also parents, they also register their kids for enrollment in schools, because the Department of Education, which is government, they've created an online platform to enable people to actually register their students. Because there's always long lines whenever people want to register people. So it's more of a convenient way of people making sure that they do get a fair chance of taking kids to whatever school that they want to take them to. We also had an impact in terms of reduction of unemployment. Because a lot of, I can just give you an example, in our community, ever since we actually installed, that's when we started looking for employment opportunities, and now we have seen lives change as a result of it. And then we've also created platforms for businesses to develop and also obtain some type of support by using online the online platform, the online presence of some businesses through creation of websites using social media for marketing and for business visibility. And then we brought down the cost of communication for some of the people that are within the community that we serve. Because now recently, as I've mentioned, that we've been charging them very low fees. So all this has resulted in improved standards of living, enhanced economy, social and human development in places where we have presence. So this is basically the network diagram of our network before the past 12 months. So as you can see on the left, we've got Terracom, which is the data center that we use. And then that's where our servers are, and then that's where our routers are. And that's where the bandwidth and the fiber will also be connected. So DFA is the one that's providing us with fiber, and then it goes straight to our high site where we have put in some sectors there to ensure that we are able to connect people around the community, because we've chosen that particular high site because it's in the center of Soweto. So when you are there, you are able to even see most of Soweto. So as you can see on the left here, from 2014 to 2016, we had one high site tower which was connected to the fiber, and then we had about 10 hotspots. And during that period, we had about 1,000 unique devices that were connecting on the network, and 150 simultaneous connections that were connected on the network. 10 households, 10 businesses, and then we had two substations during that particular period. Now, in 2017, that's where we scaled up our network by creating 3 additional substations and connecting 10 additional, we had 10 more connections on the network. But these connections, it's basically your student villages, your primary schools, and various internet cafes around Soweto. In terms of what we've done in the past 12 months, we've just recently acquired a stake of IP addresses from Affinity, and we are currently using about 25% of these IP addresses. And the allocation of the ISN, the ASN number, has enabled us to actually peer directly with other providers, allowing us to have our own IP address range independent from other ISPs that are based within Terracom. So the services that we intend to run using this dual set of IP addresses, which is a combination of your IPv4 and IPv6, we are not yet there. We are intending to actually do some hosting, some cloud services, provide some digital content, VPN, VoIP services, and also do some surveillance and streaming and gaming for local community. We've just recently got approval from NEP Africa. I don't know if they have a comment. So we've just recently reached an agreement with NEP Africa to actually be able to peer with them. So we can only conclude the peering process once we are able to actually pay the associated fees with the electoral peering itself. So work online, they're also providing us with additional payments on the network. So we also peer with them, but the only thing that we are still lacking is to get a password so that we are able to actually put an object on the SOAC affiliate portal in order to complete the entire process. Lastly, we have increased consumption of the data, moving from 200 gigs to 450 gigs, of which 300 gigs comes from Vox, which is the one that actually provided us with the initial bandwidth support, and then 150 gigs come straight from NEP Africa. And then for sustainability, we have documented our sustainability plan, and implementation in the previous months has allowed us to expand the network, but it has not never been sufficient to have to cover operational costs such as backhaul. The sustainability plan, which is centered around connecting businesses and households, has enabled us to actually operate on a daily basis, support the rental of a high side. Because we don't own a high side, we rent a high side. So transportation costs for our technical team, we are also able to finance that through the sustainability plan and procurement of wireless radios directly for young people who are gaining some of the technical skills. Due to time issues, I don't know if Brian has got anything that he wants to add, because he's one of the guys who are leading our technical department. But basically, yes, you can go to the last one. So basically, this is how our website looks like, but we've just experienced some technical problems. I don't know, maybe someone is targeting us or something. So basically, this is the online services that we intend to provide, like your e-services, making sure that people on the ground are able to access government services without having to spend money to go to government offices or, you know, queuing in long lines and stuff like that. E-learning, as I've said, e-business to ensure that local businesses are able to actually, like, make themselves available online to actually, like, reach local customers and also be able to reach the world with what they're offering in terms of products and services. In communities, it's more of making sure that the locals are able to communicate, share information, because with sharing of information within communities, that's where we see innovation starting, because it's about sharing of ideas and, like, collaborating in terms of implementation of projects or ideas themselves. E-transport is around making sure that residents, they continually get updates in terms of what is happening in the transport fraternity. Like, if I'm traveling here to Cape and I'm there, so if I can just simply go on the network, just look at the TDT and the pricing, you can just complete everything without having to actually use some extra effort. And the e-coverage basically talks to the different places